it annoys me because I have a very strong social conscience. I want to challenge the negative portrayal.
You've got to get to know the person before you can really sell on them.
There are good stories out there to be told that they're missing.
I'm a bit embarrassed, really, for them. They've got to know it's there.
Take one day off and come and leave my situation.
There's more understanding that it is a major issue for society in Britain today.
It does impact on people's sense of worth and value.
Poverty is portrayed in the media really, really negatively. The stories about people who are trying to take from the system or sponge off the system, and it doesn't really ever talk about the roots and causes of poverty.
After graduating from university in criminology and contemporary culture, I was going to pursue a career with the probation service. Found myself a single parent at the job centre, and I felt all my identity had suddenly gone. I was a proverbial single parent on benefits. That's not what I'm about.
I was from a well-off family, yet I've always been in work. It's only the last 5-6 years that I've not worked, you know.
I had to flee my home country for my safety. I was thinking that going from Cameroon to here, my life would be different. But actually, it wasn't. You know, it has been a very, very difficult situation for me. I'm quite limited, you know, to what I can do. Right. I don't have access to employment. I can't work. I'm not allowed to work. You know, so it's very difficult in that sense.
As a child, I felt devalued by people because of that and the way that it was presented. You're pigeonholed.
It came about from my knowing people who have experienced poverty and experiencing it myself and seeing the way that we were being portrayed. That made me think, as a trade unionist, there must be something we can do about this. There's already a lot of good journalism out there that does represent poverty fairly, but it's about now stopping to consider how talking about scroungers and skivers does impact on the lives of people who consume our media, who rely on us for information in their communities.
I found them quite good. What I said were put in the paper. I do know that there's somewhere that change what you say, which I disagree on, because they should get to know the person that they're talking to.
It's about dignity, and it's about how people are treated. They have a view, and they transmit that view rather than transmitting the facts.
The guidelines have been brought together by the National Union of Journalists in Manchester and Salford, working with Church Action on Poverty, also based in Salford. So this isn't journalists telling other journalists what they need to do, or trade unionists telling other people what they need to do. This is people who've experienced poverty explaining to journalists how they can better report the experience.
The great thing about these guidelines that have been produced on poverty reporting is that they have at their heart the voices of people in poverty, and that's immensely useful for journalists. Most journalists, I think, would welcome that. In my previous role at the press newspaper in York, we were involved in a two-year poverty awareness campaign, and very much at the centre of that campaign were people in York who had experienced poverty or were experiencing poverty. And I think our readers and local organisations welcomed that and were more receptive to the campaign because it had at its heart real people, our readers, their neighbours, local residents.
It's as if people are only known because they're in poverty, not about what lives they have actually got and who they are. The whole identity has been stripped away. First person in my family to go to university. I did all that as a mature student.
Yeah. I did about 12 months volunteering for him, got a qualification and ended up with 16 hours paid work, which were the best thing that happened in my life. Yeah, that I've got a qualification, it's a home bike maintenance certificate.
And he decided to expand a little bit and start putting a cafe with the bikes, doing bike runs. I actually renting bikes out now, so you could come down, get a bike and go off for the day.
Well, what do people that don't have a lot of money do on a Friday night as a treat? Because fish and chips is too expensive, so what do people do? Well, they can come here, they can be treated like they're in a restaurant, but it's a £2 meal, and that's all people pay.
When people come, they have menus, they're treated as though they were in a paying restaurant in the city centre.
Would they write that article in the way that they're writing it if it was their grandma, their sister, their cousin, their friend?
Any community that treats the poor badly is a poor community.
A lot of people in poverty, it's not their fault.
I do believe they've got the right to tell a story, but nobody in this world should be labelled.
Look up more than one source, look at the area that you're talking about in a bit more detail than just the snapshot.
To start having a discussion about how we can challenge it locally, regionally and nationally in the media.
It is authentic material from people who have seen how poverty is reported and just want to influence that and to work with journalists to ensure that the coverage is the best it can be.